First, fair, everywhere. 19 News starts now.
Good Sunday morning, and thank you so much for joining us. I'm Sia Nyorkor. Now let's get straight to the fun this morning. Lots of people getting ready for more weekend fun in downtown Cleveland for All-Star Weekend. That's where we find Anthony Lima at Play Ball Park. Anthony, tell us, how's it going? All right, thank you so much, Anthony. And of course, there's plenty of things to tell you about this morning. Now, plenty more fun happening today. The celebrity softball game and the All-Star Future game is happening today. That starts at 3. The games are back-to-back. In between the game, Joan Jett and Wesley Arms are playing live. And after all the festivities, the night finishes off with a fireworks show. And of course, there's plenty happening tomorrow as well. Play Ball Park opens at 10 a.m., where you can do everything Tony just told you. And of course, the Home Run Derby starts at 5 p.m. Cleveland's own Carlos Santana will be swinging from the bleachers. Let's get a check on whether you need your umbrellas for all of that fun. John, what can you tell us about the
All right, well, does it look like you need an umbrella here? See, it's gorgeous here.
Gorgeous.
We're on our way into a beautiful day, but a few places.
All right, John, thank you. Stay with 19 News for total team coverage of all the events surrounding the All-Star Game in Cleveland. You can find details on air, online, and all of our social media platforms. The search continues this morning as police look for whoever hit a police officer with their car. Police say they're looking for a white 2019 Jeep Compass with significant damage to the front of the car. This all happened around 4 a.m. Saturday near West 9th Street and Superior. At last check, that officer is still in the hospital with multiple broken ribs. If you recognize the car or have any information, call Cleveland Police. Now, Cleveland fans have answers this morning as to why pitcher Carlos Carrasco has been out for the last month. He's been battling leukemia.
And my mom, she was, oop, there you go, aftershock. Right there, baby.
Folks in California still feeling the effects of the earthquake this morning. This woman speaking to local news there when an aftershock happened right during her interview. The state was hit with a 7.1 magnitude earthquake in Ridgecrest, California, Friday night, just one day after Thursday's 6.4 jolt. There's more damage this time, but amazingly, no reports or injuries or deaths. Now, seismologists say there's a chance more earthquakes could happen in later on this week. Now, it wasn't fireworks that shook this neighborhood in Florida. Just take a look at this damage. Inside a vacant pizza shop, a suspected gas explosion destroyed the building and caused massive destruction to dozens of businesses in the area. The canine crews searched through the rubble. 23 people were injured. One of them was a child. Two of them are listed in critical condition. Tiring, smelly, and expensive work continues in Parma, where flash flooding interrupted this holiday weekend. Damon Maloney shows us the problem spot neighbors say need to be fixed. The city says its service crews are cleaning streets and removing debris from creeks and catch basins. Now, some sad news to share with you this morning. Disney Channel star Cameron Boyce has died. Initial reports say Boyce suffered a seizure from an ongoing medical condition and died in his sleep late last night. We won't know until autopsy results are in. Boyce starred in shows like The Descendants and the movie Grown Ups, but had been dedicating himself to charity work in the last few years. A 19 News health alert for all pet owners. The Centers for Disease Control is investigating salmonella linked to dog treats. There are 45 reports of illnesses and 13 hospitalizations linked to handling pig ear dog treats. Pet Supplies Plus is also recalling the pig-eared treats it sells in open bins. A rep for the CDC says you need to wash your hands after handling any pet treat. Now, as the 4th of July celebration of America comes to a close, what better way for CBS Morning to capture the spirit of America than by talking with members of the classic rock group, America.
Venture a highway.
John Blackstone catches up with America, plus a spin in monster trucks, and Mo Rocha takes on the mighty Mississippi. More besides ahead on Sunday morning. We'll be right back.
Live from the 19 News Center, driven by Don Joseph Toyota in Kent. This is 19 News.
The Indians have one last series before the All-Star break, but can they get any closer to the top of the division? Here's Mark Schwab with sports. The Indians aren't just hosting thousands of people during the All-Star week. They've got to feed them, too. And the culinary team at Progressive Field has developed 100 new menu items just for All-Star events. Here's a sneak peek at what they'll be serving those hungry fans. Now, lots going on downtown for All-Star Weekend. That's where we find our Anthony Lima, who's been live all morning. Anthony, is that the color run going on behind you?
Yeah, you're seeing the color run right now. What it is, a 5K. It started at Voinovich Park. They're going to wrap their way around downtown Cleveland.
All right, Anthony.
And great weather for it all. Let's take a look at a couple of graphics that include these. A day, hour by hour of isolated showers through the afternoon. We climb into the low 80s. We look at a grilling forecast at 5 and at 7 of 77 and 76 as we make our way through the evening and then slide down through the 60s. During the nighttime hours, going to be a really, really nice setup for the weekend.
All right, good to hear. Thanks so much for watching 19 News this morning. Bill Olstein is next, followed by CBS Sunday Morning. Have a great Sunday.